Number one on that list would be Cool Hand Luke. It's easily the film that I've watched the most. My wife bought a special edition original Cool Hand Luke poster, which is on my drawing room. That's how much I loved that film. And I saw it at an age where, you know, I just gotten out of college and I was, you know, trying to make sense of the big bad world out there. And suddenly everybody said I had to have a purpose in life and that I needed to be going in some direction. It was all a little too much. It was a little suffocating. It's the motion picture and the man who do not conform. So till date, I revisit that film every few months. And every time I see it, there's a new takeaway and I end up loving the film much more than I did the last time. So yeah, that'd be right up there. Second would probably be Aparojito, which is a part of the second film in the Apu trilogy. For some reason, it's just a film that moved me like no other film has. There is one more in the top five that moved me as much. Just in terms of being able to make such a minimalist film with almost no peripheral elements, nothing. It's just pure storytelling and nothing else. How that man pulled it off and how much he moves you, how much he makes you emotionally feel the anguish and the pain and the frustration of the characters, I think it's just a masterstroke. So that, I don't think I'll ever get to make a film quite that way, they'll kill me for it, but yeah, just the fact that somebody pulled it off is so amazing. Third would probably be Grave of the Fireflies. It's a Japanese anime film, and I am the sort of guy that does not cry watching films no matter what. There are only two films in my life that I've actually cried out aloud while watching them. One was this film, Grave of the Fireflies, just the most incredibly moving film. Whatever happened in Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the whole world got sold on how it was a victory, which it was. Fascism had to be defeated at that point. But that film sort of turns that perspective on its head and gives you what it felt like to be a citizen who doesn't even understand politics, who doesn't understand why the world's going to war, and all that a citizen in Japan had to face back then during World War II, immediately after the bombs had dropped in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Incredibly moving film about two kids, a brother and a younger sister. Then the other film that I love, over time, there have been lots of films that I've seen and probably thought they were better films than this one, but this one will always be special for me because it came at an age where my world views were still crystallizing, and I saw this film called All About My Mother by Pedro Almodovar. That film was just incredibly liberating for me. Had I watched it 2 years earlier, I don't think I could have made sense of the film. Had I watched it 2 years later, I don't think I would have thought it was a great film. It is a great film, mind you, but just how eventually that character in that film begins to accept anybody and everybody for who they are and stops having problems with anyone was just incredibly liberating. And I'd like to think that that sort of shaped who I wanted to become and who I eventually became to a large extent. That, you know, chill, man. Don't go around judging people. Accept people for what they are and stop trying to have problems with people. Instead, try and look at it from that point of view. That film helped me develop empathy. I think it taught me the importance of empathy. And today in our world, when everybody outrages about everything, I think that it's a great quality to have. So I wish a lot more people would watch that film and have their takeaway from that film. And fifth, this is going to be a tough one. Earlier, interestingly, Bharadwaj Rangan once asked me to write a little piece of my five favorite films, and I named Discreet Charm of the Bourgeois as my fifth film. But since then, I think I've sort of outgrown it. So I'm just going to, for nostalgia value, name the one film which I watched as a child and said, wow, this is very interesting. This seems so fresh, so new. And I think the seeds were sown that day in my head that I'd want to be in this industry and I'd want to tell stories, which is Nayagan. Incidentally, it's not even my favorite Maniratnam film anymore. My favorite Maniratnam film used to be Iruvar, now is Thalapathi. But Nayagan was, I think, the one film. I watched it around the time I was about 12 or 13. That's the film that made me fall in love with cinema. It was after Nayagan that I started actively watching films, that my taste in films became better, that I started seeking a certain reality in the films that I was watching. So yeah, for how important it is to me in my life, I think I'll put Nayagan in the fifth spot.